against them.
So,
yeah.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الله أكبر، الله أكبر. الله أكبر، الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمد أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة. حي على الفلاح، حي على الفلاح. الله
إن الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وصحبه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. أيها المسلمون والمسلمات، today inshallah ta'ala we will hear inshallah ta'ala a summary or point of the measurement and the reality of ultimate success. A lot of people, or everybody, is waking up early in the morning and they are chasing their dreams, their success. Everybody wants to achieve something in this life. But if you ask people, what is the success that you're going after? How do you measure your success? What makes your success an ultimate true success? People will give you different answers. What do you tell your children when you talk to them about success in this life? You tell them, go to school, graduate from a college, and get a job, and that is success. If you fail school, you failed. If you are successful in school, you are successful. That is what parents tell their children. And the businessmen, people who are traders and people of business, they measure their success by how much profit they maximize. How much they made this year. What is the revenue of their companies this year? And is it more than last year? That is how they measure their success. And different people have different meanings for it. Some people want to become famous on social media. And how many views they have on Instagram. That is how they measure their success. But today, we're going to see, inshallah ta'ala, how to measure a true success by looking into three different dimensions. Every day, five times a day, the Muaddin we just had a few minutes ago, he calls the Adhan. And one of the things that he calls, he says, Hayya ala salah, hayya ala falah. Come and haste to the success. Come to the salah and come to success. This success that the Muaddin is calling is way different than the one that is out there today. You turn on your TV, there is no hayya ala falah. There is no hayya ala salah. What they're calling is different success. It's a success that is short-sighted. It's a success that is limited to this life. The Muaddin here is calling to a success that is extended beyond this world. Success that is extended to Akhirah. Success that is extended to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A success that will teach you the purpose of your life. So we're going to see, inshallah ta'ala, a success that is complete. It has to have three important pillars. Number one, you must be successful with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created you. And he created you for a purpose. He gave you a specific task in this life. If you accomplish it, you're successful. And if you fail this task, that is the reality and actual failure. Not because you went bankrupt last year, or because you lost a loved one, or because your child failed in school. That is not the true loss. The true loss is when you fail to achieve your objective in this life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala explicitly says in the Quran, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. I did not create jinns and humans except for one purpose, one task, to establish servitude, to establish tawheed, to become a true servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Are you a servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And what is the meaning of being a servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Do you abstain and refrain from prohibitions of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Do you obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? هَلْ أَسْلَمْتَ لِلَّهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى. Did you submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? If your answer is yes, then you are on the path of success. But if you submitted to your own self-desires and you are shackled by the material of this world and you worship wealth and fame and favors, then you did not submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In fact, you're doomed. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, تَعْسَ عَبْدُ الدِّرْهَمْ تَعْسَ عَبْدُ الدِّينَاءِ تَعْسَ عَبْدُ الْخَمِيصَةِ. He says, wretched and perish is for the slave of dirham, the slave of dinar, the slave of beautiful garments and velvets. You know, when I was younger, I never understood hadith like this. How can somebody become a slave of his own wealth? But when you see today how people measure their success by how much they have in their accounts, regardless of how they obtain it, then you know people are enslaved by this little material of this world. And they forgot about the akhirah. The believer is different. Al-mu'min is different. He sees his success, and his success is beyond this world. Right? The poet, he says, if you lose something of this world, but your akhirah is safe, he says, don't worry. Don't worry, he says, because the ultimate loss is the one who is going to be deprived by the enjoyment of akhirah. Regardless of how good life he spent in this life, it doesn't matter if you are among the losers in akhirah. And this is clear in the Quran. So if you fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, haqqa tuqati, and you follow the path of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you are successful. Even if you spend some of your life here in poverty and deprived from some enjoyment of this life, you're still successful. I'm saying this because we live in a place and time where we are so much fed into a different ideology. An ideology that exclusively sees this world and classifies people based on this world. And it's very easy to fall for that. Very easy that you lose sight when haqiqatul najah. And you start to think that if you are successful with your job, you have a good job, you graduate, your children go to school, and you live in a good neighborhood, you're fine. Even if you don't pray. Even if you don't know anything about La ilaha illallah. Even if your tawheed is not established. Because that is what the news is telling you. That is what is on the newspapers.
That is what is played in the movies. That is what is in the reality TV shows. Everything that you look, they're telling you your American dream is to have a house and freedom and have a good stable job. Once you have that, they tell you you're a free man. But look around people today. Are they really free people? Do they have freedom in their lives? If you look closer, you find they're not free. These are people that are really, really enslaved by their desires and lustful desires. A lot of people are enslaved by bottles of alcohol. A lot of them are enslaved by drugs. They are shackled by their own sins. And they worship their self-desires and shaitan. They are not free. A free man is the one who is a servant to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Every time you see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala calling Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he calls him abd, slave. Subhanalladhi asra bi'abdihi. Allah says subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He's a free man that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala elevated him to be the slave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Tabarakalladhi nazzala al-furqana ala 'abdihi liyakuna lil'alamin nadhira. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioning, anytime he mentions him as 'abd, is because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions this in a positive connotation, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give him a status. And remember, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was a poor man. He did not have a lot of mansions and houses and money and fortune. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made him the best of the creation. Look into the generation of the Sahaba radiallahu anhu, the best generation of all time. There was no generation better than the generation of the Sahabas. What did they have? They had Iman and Amal Salih. They had Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as their role model. And once they achieved that, radiallahu anhum wa radu anhum, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala became pleased with them. And they were pleased with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah granted them Jannah while they're still on the earth. So once you are successful with your relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you are indeed have accomplished your primary task. Number two is you must be successful with people, your relationship with people. How many people around you that you have a relationship with? Your parents, your spouse, your children, your students, your teachers, your colleagues, your partners in business, your friends, your neighbors. All these people you have relationship with them. Are you successful with these relationships? Are you just and fair to them? Do you guide them? Do you agree with them when they're right and disagree with them when they're wrong? What is your relationship looks like with these people? Right? If you are successful with the relationships that are surrounding you, then you are successful. But if you have money, you even go to the masjid, but you are a terrible spouse, you mistreat your wife and your husband, then you are not successful. Your success has a defect in it. And this is a result of your failure with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because when Allah subhanahu, you are successful with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah grants you light to distinguish between the right and wrong. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِن تَتَّقُوا اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَكُمْ فُرْقَانًا. If you fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah grants you a light, a furqan, that will guide you to distinguish between the haqq and batil, the truth and falsehood, between guidance and misguidance. Allah grants you this when you really fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah will guide you to treat your spouse the way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants you to treat them. Allah will grant you the light to treat your children and upbring them Islamically. But if you fail with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you also will fail with your kids, with your household, and people that you're responsible for. Right. Inshallah ta'ala, on the second khutbah, we'll finish the last point. نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يلهمنا رشدنا ويجعلنا ممن يستمعون القول فيتبعون أحسنه إنه ولي ذلك والقادر عليه. الحمد لله على إحسانه والشكر له على توفيقه وامتنانه، صلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. أما بعد، أيها المسلمون عباد الله، the last point that will complete your success and give you a success that is a complete success both in this life and آخرة is when you are successful with your own self. وَمَنْ يُوقَ شُحَّ نَفْسِهِ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ. One who has been prevented from the stinginess of his own self is indeed a successful person. You must train yourself. You must train yourself to become the servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You must block yourself from following desires. You must win over yourself. They say Ali ibn Abi Talib radiyallahu anhu, he says, you will not enter the Jannah until when you overcome and you overpower yourself, your own soul. Because your soul, إِنَّ نَفْسَ لَأَمَّارَةٌ بِالسُّوءِ, your soul that is between in your chest, that soul itself guides you and pushes you to commit haram. You must resist that through the Quran and Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And once you win over yourself, you train yourself, take care of your body, take care of your brain, take care of your heart, and take care of your soul. Purify your soul with the Quran and Sunnah, with ibadah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Train your brain by educating yourself, reading and contemplating and pondering on the ayatul kawniya wal quraniya. And train your body by exercising and staying healthy, taking care of yourself with good diet. Don't destroy yourself. Don't lose control. If you destroy your health, how are you going to stand up for Qiyamul Layl? How are you going to be able to fast Ramadan? How are you going to do jihad? Of course, you have to take care of yourself. The Sahabas, the Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, were healthy people and strong people, mentally and physically strong people. Right? So you must be successful in managing your own self. And that will make you a successful person in this life, and reputable person in this life, and a person that is successful in akhirah. فَمَنْ زُحْزِحَ عَنِ النَّارِ وَأُدْخِلَ الْجَنَّةَ فَقَدْ فَازْ. One who has been distanced from hellfire and admitted in Jannah, that is indeed the successful person. اللهم إنا نسألك الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم، وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين، إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم إنا نسألك الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه، وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. اللهم ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. وأقيموا الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمد رسول الله.
حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
استو واعتدل وتراصوا بين الصفوف استقيموا اعتدلوا الله أكبر أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين قد أفلح من تزكى وذكر اسم ربه فصلى بل تؤثرون الحياة الدنيا والآخرة خير وأبقى إن هذا لفي الصحف الأولى صحف إبراهيم وموسى الله سمع الله لمن حمده
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر
الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين قد أفلح من زكاها وقد خاب من دساها كذبت ثمود بطغواها إذ انبعث أشقاها فقال لهم رسول الله ناقة الله وسقياها فكذبوه فعقروها فدمدم عليهم ربهم بذنبهم فسواها ولا يخاف عقباها الله
سمع الله لمن حمده.
الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. جزاك الله خيرا شيخ محمود for your beautiful خطبة. May Allah عز وجل accept from you and from all of us.